Perryman. That might give Spurs a bit of encouragement now. Forbes under a lot of pressure now from Chivers, but he's again sticking to it well and saves the corner. Tottenham's throw, though, and I think it'd probably be a long one by Chivers. He was already there on the spot. And again, Mike England's going forward. Again, a lower one. Chivers with a back heel. Now Mike England hoping to get in. Coates hoping to blast it in. And Coates has done it. Ralph Coates. A beautiful shot by Coates. And again, the long throw has put Norwich in trouble. Nodded out. And finally coming to Ralph Coates. With 18 minutes left, the substitute scores a cracking goal. Cross again, and cross goes in. Paddon gamely coming up on the outside. Graham Paddon, tremendous play by him. And a dangerous overhead kick by Cross, giving Spurs a chance to collect themselves again and get a free kick. Billy Nicholson showing no emotion, but you would really know him never to show emotion. All he wants is more effort. Saunders is a bit disappointing for him. Now he's telling his side to come up more. And indeed, Norwich must open it out now. The stifling has got to stop. And now they've got to make chances for themselves. Paddon, Blair with his arm in the air, getting his header down. Pierce thought about passing that back to Jennings. That would have been dangerous. And that at least is safe for the moment, but it's with Livermore. Blair is down and injured in the area. Anderson was right up. And Perryman now to bring it away again for Tottenham. That should set Chivers' legs going. Forbes there with him. And Chivers now on the rampage again. Right foot and straight at Kevin Keelan. But as Norwich start flinging a few men forward, so Chivers might have a little more room to exploit his pace against that of Forbes. Blair is still injured on the edge of that Spurs penalty area. Norwich sub beginning to take his tracksuit off. Trevor Howard. And it looks as though Blair might be helped off. So when they need a little more striking force, it's a striker who goes off. Trevor Howard, best better known as a midfield player, score of 2 goals this season. Having his studs inspected by referee David Smith. Who's had a good cup final, David Smith. Turns it in once more, a good one, and a very good catch, and he's lost it. And Perryman winkling it away. And Kinnear, who finally got it away, but Pat Jennings under a lot of pressure there, caught it and lost it. Duncan Forbes. High again there, Cross is homing in on it, but Mike England away to Kinnear. Butler again. And finally, Chivers sticks out a long leg and it's with Coates once more. Chivers not quite getting to that one, but Peter's picking up the loose one and it's with Pierce. Knowles outside it, and it was beautifully played there for Cyril Knowles. The cross, all against the post. Chivers, no. Screaming shot there from Knowles, who had scored only one goal previously this season. Thought a dream. was coming through there with another one at Wembley. And so much then for these tremendous underdogs. They've given Spurs a fright or two, so much so that the Spurs fans are already beginning to whistle to give a hint to the referee, David Smith, but there are still a couple of minutes to go. And it's with Buckler, the number three. And a corner given, because that must have bobbled off the Spurs defender. And it's not all up yet. Norwich now piling everybody forward. Duncan Forbes right up there. If talking could win matches, he'd be a winner every week, I would think. He never gives up. Anderson with the header. Howard also trying to get in, but again it was the fist of Jennings. Two Spurs players are down as it's crossed again towards Duncan Forbes. And just a fraction wide. And a little few recriminations in that Spurs defence. Forbes was just a fraction away with that one. Philip Beale was having a go at Alan Gilzean, maybe for not picking up Forbes. Forbes, I think, sensing that might have been a golden chance that has gone forever. Knowles, a high ball forward, and that's it! And Spurs have won the cup that they won 2 years ago, and they've become the first side ever to win it twice. The only goal of the League Cup final of 1973 going to the number 12, the substitute Ralph Coates. Saunders and Billy Nicholson, the two managers going out. Great respect for each other. And so Spurs have done it. They kept plugging away at that Norwich defence, and nobody more so than Steve Perryman. There's a plug for the big match. It was a big match here today that never quite fulfilled all the expectations. But with the likes of Perryman, before he went off so tragically, John Pratt, and Mike England at the back, and Pat Jennings as well. Spurs just about had the edge, translated by that single goal from Ralph Coates. So Duncan Forbes gets a tankard from, there's the Spurs chairman, Sidney Whale, from the Earl of Harwood. Hard luck, Norwich. You put up a brave fight, says the scoreboard, and who on earth at Wembley this afternoon could argue with that? So Spurs have done it again. And Martin Peters forgot his tackle. Mike England, magnificent at the back. But who's the real hero, of course? The man who scores the winner, Ralph Coates. And after so many disappointments at White Hart Lane, good to see it work out for him as well. Cyril Knowles, Jimmy Pearce, Steve Perryman, Joe Kinnear, Martin Chivers, so beautifully marked all afternoon by Duncan Forbes, Pat Jennings, some marvellous catching by him, and the unluckiest man, I suppose, at Wembley, John Pratt. Wembley for him meant 20 minutes before the agony of a twisted knee. Commiserations from the Spurs chairman and Philip Beale. So the Wembley team have done it again. The cup final specialists go into Europe again next season, certainly as holders of the Football League Cup, and they give it to Ralph Coates, the man who's come out of the shadows to steal the headlines with the winning goal at Wembley. A tankard in his hand and a cup on his head. That's the picture of a winner, Ralph Coates.